Hey, SmartPak fans. Welcome to a special edition of Ask the Vet. You may notice I'm sitting on this side, not that side. I'm Dr. Lydia Gray, the Staff Veterinarian and Medical Director at SmartPak. This is Nerida Richards, PhD. I'm going to let you introduce yourself.
Sure. Thanks, Lydia. So I'm Nerida. I'm an equine nutritionist from Australia, which is probably quite obvious given my accent.
I was going to say far.
Yeah.
Obvious. True.
I work as a consulting nutritionist in Australia. I formulate feeds and supplements for companies all over the world. And I also run the feedxl.com website, which is a nutrition calculator that horse owners use to put their horses' diets together.
We love it. Yeah. Great. We ask you to submit your horse nutrition questions specifically, and then this segment will answer one of those questions. You'll answer one of those questions. I'm helping. And then to see the other questions, just click on the playlist at the end of the video, and you get to see them all. So, ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Ready. Our next question is from Tiffany A. Perry from Instagram, and she asks, can horses receive all of their chain amino acids from hay? What are side effects of chain amino acid deficiency other than loss of muscle development?
Mm-hmm. Okay. So amino acids come from protein. So most things are made up of building blocks. So the building blocks of protein are called amino acids.
Okay.
There's 20 of them. 10 of them are what we call non-essential. So the horse, if it needs it, can just make it in its own body. So it takes building blocks from various places for the amino acid itself and puts the amino acid together and then uses it wherever it needs to. The other 10 amino acids we call essential amino acids, and all that means is it must come in from the diet.
Okay.
Because the horse can't make it for themselves. So there's 10 of these, and there's three that we really focus on because they're what we call the most limiting amino acids. So they're the ones that when a horse runs out of them, whatever it was trying to do using that amino acid has to stop. So yes, muscle development is certainly something that a horse requires all these essential amino acids to achieve. But, you know, everything's built of protein. So something you're probably really going to notice if a horse becomes amino deficient is declining hoof health, because the hooves require a lot of methionine, which is one of the essential amino acids. But, you know, every essential amino acid is in hoof tissue. So that's one thing you would notice. I mean, most of the body is made up of protein. I'm sure we see bone development issues in young horses when they're on amino deficient diets. And there's really, I mean, like organ health would suffer. Everything would suffer.
Yeah.
Not dramatically with small deficiencies. And you're right. The first thing really we notice is just either a horse losing muscle, and this is really evident actually in lactating mares, so mares with a foal at foot, because they have huge protein requirements trying to make milk for their foal, and if they're not getting the essential amino acids in what we're feeding them, they have this huge reserve in their own muscle. And they, good mares would prefer to use their own muscle reserves to make milk for their foal.
Yep.
And so you will see these mares will just, they mine their own body reserves. Yep. And so they will lose their top line, they'll lose all the muscle of their rump, and they'll lose it all around their shoulders, and they just become very angular looking because they have no muscle left. Where if you feed them, I mean, we use in our breeding feeds, we use a lot of soybean protein based rations for breeding horses, and we can maintain mares with the most glorious top lines and rumps.
Soy is a very high quality protein because it's got so many of the essential amino acids.
It does.
And they're high in lysine, which was the
high in lysine, high in methionine, high in threonine.
Yeah.
So we rank proteins with this. We don't really talk about it so much, but there's what is called a biological value, and it may be old terminology now, but I certainly still think of it this way, in that the closer an amino acid profile of a food ingredient is to the amino acid requirements of whatever is eating it, the higher the biological value.
Yep.
So whey protein, protein, isolate whey protein concentrate that your bodybuilders use as their post-training supplement, it's close to 100. Like it's so, the amino profile of whey protein is so close to what we need as humans that it's got a really
eggs.
High. Egg whites, egg whites down in the 80s somewhere. But soybean is the highest ranked plant protein.
Right.
So out of all the plant, because we don't feed generally eggs or a lot of whey to horses. We do, I love whey for horses, but it's expensive generally and needs to be fed strategically. So soy protein is the most economical plant-based protein right. that also has a really good amino profile. I think I found, I have two kids. And I find now I try to explain things in very visual terms. And I discovered that that my kids' building blocks are actually a really neat way to show people what happens when you run out of amino acids.
Okay.
So if you imagine, let's imagine this is a piece of soybean protein.
All right.
And we'll say the blue blocks are non-essential amino acids. We don't know what they're called, we don't really care. And then the red we'll say is methionine, the yellow lysine, and the green threonine.
Okay.
So these are our essential aminos. Now what happens when a horse eats a protein like this? Goes into the small intestine and enzymes, so specific protein mm-hmm. digesting enzymes, which I just think of like a little pair of scissors, come along and cut this protein into its amino acids. So they're all floating around in the gut, very, very close to the brush border, so right on the surface of the intestine. And then they'll be absorbed. So from the gut, they'll be absorbed into the horse's body and they're now circulating around in the blood. Now this particular horse has just done a bit of a workout and his muscles are going, I need to build up.
Okay.
I want to be stronger. And so the muscles will start looking for the essential amino acids that it wants to put together in a muscle protein, finds the soybean protein that's been absorbed and starts putting it back together. Now it's not going to be exactly the same as a soybean protein because it's no longer soybean. But it'll put it back and it'll form a muscle fiber.
Okay.
So similar, it's all the same amino acids in there, but it's now a muscle fiber and not a soybean. And this is, you know, you think of, there must be millions of different proteins mm-hmm. in the world, and they're all made out of these 20
the same building
amino
blocks,
acids.
Just different
yep.
order.
So
yep.
different lengths, different order. Mm-hmm. They're all different. So what I ask people to do is say, okay, let's make that exact protein out of the proteins that we've been fed. So your horse has been fed that protein,
okay.
my horse has been fed this protein, and we'll see if we can reconstruct this
okay.
protein. Now the only rule is, when you get to a colour you don't have, you have to stop. Because you can't substitute any old amino acid in to a spot where you don't have an essential
okay.
amino acid, because then you're making a different protein.
Right.
Okay?
Got it.
All right, let's see how we go.
Okay, here we go.
Reishi.
Uh-oh, wait. I think you've done this before, though.
Many times.
I'm beating you. Oh.
Oh, Lydia had to stop.
Oh.
Oop, and now I'm doing it wrong.
Because I don't have a yellow one.
So, yeah, so you've run out of yellow. So I had
even
all
though,
the
Even though I
acids,
have more of these,
you have,
I don't have any yellow, so I have to stop.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
So you now, I mean, the body would break that back down
yeah.
or hang around. Or not, but you can't build a muscle protein because
right.
you didn't get all the way to
so
the
I,
end.
So this horse wasn't able to recover from his workout.
No.
Or that a four horse wasn't able to make it maybe to a five because he couldn't develop his top line because
yeah.
the muscle wasn't there.
Yeah. We see this a lot in Australia. We have a lot of poor quality protein in our feeds because soybean protein is quite expensive.
In Australia?
Because
oh,
we have to import
it's
it
very cheap
from here.
Oh,
So it has
okay.
to travel. Australia is a long way away.
I've heard that.
So it's expensive and we have a lot of cottonseed meal. And the interesting
and
thing...
And what's the quality, the protein quality of cottonseed meal?
Well, it's low, so it's missing essential amino acids. But the interesting thing with cottonseed meal is when they heat it to get the oil out, gossypol, which is the toxic
yep,
stuff
yep.
in cottonseed, it deactivates itself, which is good because
yeah.
then it becomes
right.
safe to feed. But its favourite way to deactivate itself is by grabbing hold of lysine.
Oh.
So there's lysine there, but it's got this gossypol
yep.
hanging onto it.
Yep.
And so it goes into the gut. And it can't get into the body.
It's not usable.
No.
It's not available.
No. So, so you know, it's common for me to see mares with foals at foot on feeds that look like they have plenty of protein. You know, they might be 16-18% protein, and yet they're losing their top line because they don't have the lysine, and the mares have to break like a whole muscle fiber down just to get the lysine. We're on those poor quality proteins. So it makes a big difference.
Boy.
Or they will not, if you have your horses on a protein like this, they just will not build top line, regardless of how much you work them, because they don't have the building materials
yeah.
to do it.
Wow.
Hmm.